हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दी डिजायर क्वालिटी ऑफ प्रोडक्टिव रिलेइंग। फर्स्ट डिजायर क्वालिटी इज अ रिलायबिलिटी, ओके, एबिलिटी ऑफ प्रोटेक्टिव सिस्टम टू ऑपरेट अंडर दी प्री डिटरमाइंड कंडीशन इज फॉल इन अ रिलायबिलिटी कंडीशन एंड रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ माल फंक्शन और नॉट एबल टू ऑपरेट, ओके, अचीव्ड बाय रिडंडेंसी। It means that duplicate the relaying system, okay? And threats. What are the threats to reliability? It's a loss relay contacts, the contamination of circuit breaker contacts, aging of spring mechanism. Okay, so these are the threats to reliability. Okay, reliability of protective system scheme is 95%. Okay, then we have a selectivity, ability of protective system to isolate faulty section exclusively from the rest of the healthy system is known as a selectivity. Okay, so two types of selectivity are addressed. One is a absolute selectivity, protective system that detects the fault for its own zone, for example differential protection. Okay, so this is the absolute selectivity, and relative selectivity is a protective system that can detect the faults of other zone. Okay, so for example distance protection. So both the system for differential protection system, these are the selectivity is this type of absolute selectivity, and for a distance protection, selectivity is a type of relative selectivity. Okay, then we have another quality, desired quality, which is the discrimination. Okay, so ability of protective system to discriminate between fault and overloading conditions. So this is the most important thing, that we have to discriminate. And fault is a abrupt increase in a current, instantaneous operation of relay. Okay, so overload is a gradual increase in a current. Okay, so this is the main difference between the fault and overload. Okay, so discrimination between fault current and inrush current is a transformer energized at the instant of zero crossing of primary voltage. Okay, and so to discriminate the fault and inrush, we have to do this. Transformer should energize at an instant of zero crossing of primary voltage, and inductive circuit draws a maximum current of 10 to 15 times the rated current. Okay, so discrimination should be done between this inrush and fault current. Then discrimination between fault current and starting current. Okay, so at starting, no counter EMF in the rotor of induction motor for a short time. So whenever we start the induction motor, then at that time we have a starting high starting current, and we have to discriminate this with the fault current. Okay, so stator draws maximum current about 5 to 10 times the rated current. Okay, and fourth one is a speed. Okay, fourth desired quality is a speed. Faster operation of relay and circuit breaker is needed, very needed, and it reduces and damages to the equipment, improves the stability. Okay, fault clearing time is a time of relay operation plus time of breaker operation. Okay, and good protective system, fault clearing time is less than 4 cycles. Then fifth one is a stability. So ability of protective system to remain in operative when fault current is flowing through its protective zone, for the fault that does not lie in this its zone. Okay, so we have to maintain a zone in a stability mode, stable mode. Okay, so for example unit protection and differential protection. Then sixth one is a sensitivity. Okay, so minimum value of actuating quantity, current or voltage at which protective system operates is known as a sensitivity, and operating principle influences the sensitivity. And for numerical relays, highest sensitivity needed. For static relay, we have also higher sensitivity, and electromagnetic relay also have a higher sensitivity. Okay, fault current less than full load current also influence the sensitivity. Okay, so fault current, if fault current is less than the full load current, then it will affect the sensitivity and also operation of the all the protect system. Okay, so voltage dip, like what type of fault in which we have a fault current is less than the full load current, such as a voltage dip, unbalanced line voltage, and 5 to 6 time more heat due to the sequence current and zero sequence current. Okay. Then we have another quality required, economy. As a thumb rule, the protective system should not cost more than 5% of total cost. So this is a thumb rule, and cost cutting must not compromise the safety and stability of system. So both things are very, very important, that cost should not be increased more than 5%, and if we compromise in a cost, then it does not mean that we compromise with the safety and stability of the system. Okay, so this is the some cost, average cost. Relays is cost 0.55%. CDBT control circuit equipments are cost about 4%, and panels and wiring are cost about 0.4%. Okay, so the overall cost is 4.95%, which is approximately equal to a 5%. Okay, so large system economically unjustified to use an ideal scheme of protection. Okay, so now we have a last quality, which is a simplicity, helps to maintain the protective system easily and improve the reliability. Okay, now we have now we are going to classify the protective relays. So according to technology, we have a three type. First one is a electromechanical relay, then we have a static relay, and third one is a numerical. So these three type is according to technology. In electromechanical, we use the electromechanical system. In static system, we use the power electronics based circuits, and in numerical relays, we also use the power electronics, but it's some have some storage and also some recording type of capacity. Okay, so these are the types, depends on the technology. Okay, then we have a types based on the speed of operation. Okay, so instantaneous relay, then we have a time delay relays, then we have a inverse time relays. Okay, so these are the types depend on the speed of operation. Then according to functionality, we have a four types, sorry, four. We have many types that depends on the functionality. First one is overcurrent relays. Then we have a over and under voltage relay, over under frequency relay, okay, impedance relay, directional relay, and many more. Okay, so depends on the functionality. If we use the overcurrent relays, then it will look after for the current. Okay, so whenever the current is above the set value, then it will gets open. Then we have a over and under voltage relay, so it observes the voltage changes. Then we have a over and under frequency relay, then it observes the frequency changes. Okay, so impedance relay, directional relay. So there are many modes depend on the functionality. Then according to number of inputs, we have a single input relay, dual input relay, multi input relay. Okay, so these are the classification. So based on technology, we have a electromagnetic relay. So now we take some brief introduction of the relays classification. And first one is based on technology, and it is further divided in a electromechanical relays. Then it contains the electromagnet, permanent magnet, and moving part. Two types relay we have. First one is a attracted armature type, and second one is a induction type. Okay, attracted armature type responds to AC and DC both quantity. Okay, and induction type relay only respond for AC quantity. Then we have a static relay. So you can also see the figures of how relays are look like. Static relays are electronic circuit compares input quantities and generate the output signal, and output signal is applied to slave relay. Okay, so advantage is a low CDBT burden and fast operation and long life. Disadvantage is a high cost and skilled manpower for repair. Then we have a numerical relay. So collects, process, and discriminate the data in a digital form. So I already told that it has some system that can process the data. Okay, and it is based on microprocessor, microcontroller, DSP are the key components. And advantage is a low CTPT burden, compact, self-monitoring, and self-checking capability, multiple functionality. Okay, so these are the some advantage. Now, based on speed of operation, we have a instantaneous type relay. Okay, so it operates as soon as actuating quantity crosses the pickup value, and there is no intentional time delay is set, and used as a overcurrent protection of distribution feeder. Then we have a time delay relays. Operates after a definite time, however actuating quantity has crossed the pickup value, and time setting and pickup adjustment are provided. Use as a backup protection of distance relay of transmission line, differential relay for transformer. Okay, so these are these types based on the speed of operation. First one is instantaneous, which is open as soon as the fault current reaches to the pickup value. Then we have a time delay type relays. Okay, and third one is a inverse time. So as the current high, as the current is gone beyond the limit, or if current is very high, then it will operate quickly. Okay, so the relay operates more quickly if current quantity is high. So time of operation is inversely depend. Okay, so these are the curve for all these three type of speed operation. Then based on functionality, we have a overcurrent relay. Okay, operates when the current exceeds the certain limit. Then we have a over and under voltage relays, operates when the voltage reaches to a certain over or under voltage preset limit. Then we have a frequency relay, which operates when a frequency reaches to a over or under frequency preset limit. Then we have impedance relay, measure the line impedance between the relay location and the point of fault, and operates in the point of fault lies within the protection system. Okay, then we have a direction, checks whether the fault of whether point of fault lies in a forward or reverse direction, and then open. Okay, so you can see here in the diagram we have a many type of relays attached in the system, in which you can see here from the first here we have a voltage balance, and over frequency relays are there, over voltage relays are there. Loss of synchronization, to detect the loss of synchronization, we use the voltage frequency relays. And there are many types of relay used depend on the purpose of protection. Okay, and based on number of inputs, we have a single input relays, only one input signal is available, known as level detectors, and monitors one input quantity and compare it with the reference quantity. Simplest in a construction and operation, just like the overcurrent relay. Okay, so this is a single input relay. Then we have a dual input relays. Two input signals are available. Measure the one quantity, compare it with the another quantity, and types are amplitude comparator and phase comparator. Okay, and example is the distance and differential type relays are a dual input type relay. Okay. And third one is a multi-input relays, in which we have a more than two input signals are available, and realize spatial characteristics other than straight lines or a circle. Okay, so what are the types? Amplitude comparator, elliptical, hyperbolic, and phase comparator. And example of this type relay is a distance relay. Okay, so distance relay have a many inputs. Okay, multiple input relays. So whenever you ask about the what is the classification of the protective relays, so you divide all the relays based on the its input. Okay, based on these four categories. Okay, based on number of inputs, based on quantity, and based on the functionality. Okay, and based on the value. Okay, so these are the four classification criteria, and you have to mention all these relays. Okay, and if any question asked about a certain classification, like if a question is only asked about the what is the or you can, if examiner asks that explain the classification of protective relay based on the number of inputs, so and in that particular case you have to mention the all the types and explain it in a proper manner. Okay, so this is it for today. In next lecture we will discuss the classification of electromagnetic relays, like what is a relay, electromagnetic relay, and how this will classify and how it operates. Okay, so in next lecture we will see for the classification of electromagnetic relays. So if you have any doubt, then you can comment it down.